I'm at the Firestone Walker tasting room, actually, but the Firestone Walker Brewery in Paso Robles, California. And I just took a tour of their brand new brewing facility, which I haven't seen before. And there's just more technology than I've ever seen in a brew house. It's usually I can kind of make my way around, but this one is just amazing. Give me the rundown of the new facility and, you know, compared to the old one, because you didn't tear out the old brew house.
No, what we basically did was just add to our existing system. So the original four vessel system that we started with is a 50 barrel system. Those vessels are a mash mixer, a lauter tun, a wort kettle or a boiling kettle, and a whirlpool. And what we've done is basically separated what would be typically a combination vessel into its two separate functions. So with a four vessel system, we can actually get 8 brews through the system in a 24-hour period. Our current program, we mash in every 3 hours, so it's a fast-paced environment. So we went with a new lauter tun. We added a new boiling kettle and converted the old kettle into what we call a wort receiving vessel. So while a lauter tun is actively running wort off, we would collect that wort in a new vessel and then later move it to the kettle for boiling. And then we added some new toys for pure technology and quality reasons.
Okay.
We added a wet mill. We kept the old dry mill, so we kept the flexibility of being able to mill both ways.
What does the wet mill do?
The wet mill has a couple of advantages over dry milling. One simply is that it takes care of all the dust. More importantly, the technology allows us to steep whole kernel grain in advance of milling. That hydrates the husk and makes it pliable and starts to hydrate the endosperm as well. And then we add our mash water while we're milling. In essence, you're mashing in the mill.
So then it goes from that wet mill, and it actually, this was interesting to me to see, pumps up through the bottom of a vessel.
Yeah, the technology, the newer technology in brew houses is trying to do all of your transfers from one vessel to another from bottom to bottom. And again, this is to keep aeration down and to create a really nice gentle transfer. So you saw the same thing with the new lauter tun. Instead of dropping the grain in from above, which would be the easiest and what you see most frequently, this literally pumps it then again in from below, spreads very evenly over the floor, and then is very gentle for the start of the other transfers.
All right, what's next from there?
We've converted our old kettle into a wort receiving vessel that has steam on that vessel still, so we can preheat wort up to boiling temperature, and then as soon as our kettle is ready to receive it, we can quickly pump that wort over and then immediately start boiling. With that kettle, we built hop dosing vessels.
Okay, these
so,
are cool.
Yeah, not having to open the door of the kettle and add hops, as ridiculous as that might seem, is actually quite dangerous. We don't have to haul hops up to the upper deck and throw them in the door. We add them to small vessels underneath the brew house, which we then close and cap. We pump wort from the kettle through the hop dosing vessel and sweep the hops back to the kettle. We added a special fourth vessel to our system so that as we're pumping to the whirlpool, we can also sweep hops to the whirlpool. And then we did replace our old whirlpool because there's new technology available that gives us better efficiency and better separation. However, the people designing these systems typically don't add 1 pound, 2 pounds, 3 pounds of hops per barrel to their brews. So even this new whirlpool is still not quite up to our standards for separating hops away from wort, but we'll figure it out and get there. We have what we call the hot liquor tank, and that's set between 75 and 80 degrees C, so it's hotter than most brewing applications. So we start the day out by steam heating that vessel, and then we would start doing our brews, and then when we get to the point of cooling in our wort heat exchange system, we're actually using chilled brewing water against hot wort, picking up that heat energy and deriving it back to the hot water tank. The way the heat exchange system is set up, it will create water at between 75 and 80 degrees C. So by the nature of the system, we need to have blending systems to blend that water temperature down. We bought an automated blending kit that allows us to blend water to different destinations at exact temperatures without having to turn valves. And we're going to try to get from 8 brews a day to 16 brews a day.
Wow.
And that means the brewer needs to move fast. And so we brought the automation on board specifically to take away tasks that could be done just as well by a computer to allow the brewer to concentrate on those tasks that a computer can't do that are quality driven.
I'm telling you, it's a beautiful brew house. I haven't seen a brew house that has almost as much wires running through it as it does hoses. You've got a wonderful brew deck up there. You guys are brewing awesome beer, man. Thanks for having us.
Thanks for coming and visiting.
All right, I'm not leaving though. staying for more beer.